Watch. Learn. Discover. Welcome to the learning program on the titration technique. This program will take you approximately 15 minutes to complete. A post-test is provided to help you evaluate your knowledge. Hello. Welcome to my lab. My name is Jane, and I'm a biochemistry teacher. Today we are going to talk about titration. Have you ever wanted to know how a scientist can determine the exact concentration of a dissolved substance in a solution? Well, the answer is titration. Titration is a technique used to determine the concentration of a solution with a solution of known concentration. Now, let's have a look at the equipment we need to run a titration. First, you need a magnetic stirrer. This device is designed to mix the solution being investigated. Then, you need a conical flask which is placed onto the magnetic stirrer. A stir rod is placed in the flask. A known volume is added to the solution being investigated to the conical flask. This solution of unknown concentration is called the analyte. The analyte is the solution being investigated. You must accurately measure out the volume of the analyte placed in the flask. This volume is VA. Add one or two drops of an appropriate indicator to the solution being investigated. Turn the magnetic stirrer on. The stir rod starts rotating. The next equipment you need is a stand and a burette clamp. Then, you need a burette. The burette is mounted on a stand with the clamp. The burette is a graduated glassware designed to deliver and measure accurately liquids. It is graduated with a scale in millimeters and tenth of millimeters. It has a tap at its lower end, also called a stopcock. The burette is filled with a solution of a reagent of exactly known concentration. This solution is called the titrant or the standard solution. The titrant is added in small portions until the indicator just changed its color. Drip titrant into the analyte until change of color is permanent. Observe the reaction closely to detect sudden changes in color. To increase contrast, you can place white paper in between flask and stirrer. Slowly drip the titrant and keep watching closely to the reaction in the flask. When a change in color has occurred, it is called the end point of the titration. Now the experiment is over, we must determine the exact concentration of the unknown solution. How can we work it out? The volume added from the burette is calculated as the difference between the initial and final volume of titrant read from the scale of the burette. This volume is BT. Calculations are then performed to find the unknown concentration of the analyte. If the titrant and analyte have a 1:1 mole ratio, the following equation can be used to determine the unknown concentration. The module on titration is over.